These are the three ways anyone can make $1,000 per week profit selling on eBay. G'day guys, my name is Samson. I'm a full-time eBay seller and I have been for just about 6 months. In my experience, there are three main ways that anyone can make at least $1,000 per week selling on eBay. These are methods I've used myself to consistently generate over $10,000 in monthly eBay sales, but only two out of the three methods that I'm going to be sharing with you today are ones that I would actually recommend. I believe that selling on eBay is one of the best and easiest ways to make money online right now. And while this obviously differs person to person, I feel that $1,000 per week is generally what is considered enough to live off as a full-time income. So today I'm going to be explaining how anyone can make that amount of money on eBay. Just quickly guys, on this channel, I make all types of videos about selling on eBay and making money online. So if that sounds like something that interests you, make sure to drop a like on the video and also subscribe to my channel if you are new. Now let's get right into it. All right, the first way to make $1,000 per week profit selling on eBay is flipping products or reselling. This involves buying products from thrift shops, garage sales, or sites such as Facebook Marketplace, buying them for a low price, and then reselling them on eBay for a profit. This is a great way to make money on eBay that I document on this YouTube channel. I've been flipping products on eBay for about 2 years now. I've sold over 3,000 items on eBay and done over $100,000 in sales. From my own experience and also talking to others, in order to make $1,000 per week selling on eBay flipping products, you'd need to be doing just about $1,700 in sales. That is for a 60% profit margin on the products that you sell. The initial investment required to start flipping products on eBay is very low. I started reselling with only a few hundred dollars that I got for my 18th birthday. I would recommend having at least $100 to invest to start reselling products on eBay. However, you can actually start with less simply by flipping products that you already have in your home that you no longer use. Another advantage of flipping, reselling products on eBay is that it is actually very scalable. You can grow your business from something you do part-time for a little bit of extra money as a side hustle to something that generates a full-time income like I have. I have a video on this channel that you can find here on the 10 different ways that I find products to resell on eBay, and I definitely recommend watching that if you want to get into flipping. The key to scaling a reselling business to generating $1,000 per week profit is having a lot of different ways that you can actually get inventory for your eBay business. So I wouldn't recommend just relying on thrifting. Also look into garage sales and online sales sites such as Facebook Marketplace, Gumtree, Craigslist. Depending on where you are in the world, those will be the sites that you'll go to in order to find products to resell on eBay. The downside of reselling on eBay is that it does take a fair amount of storage space once you get a good amount of inventory, and also that many people do find it hard to scale a reselling business beyond say $10,000 to $20,000 in monthly sales. In no way is that to say that that is not possible, because many people do exceed those numbers, but many do struggle to break through that barrier because they have trouble finding different ways that they can consistently bring in inventory. And also, in order to scale a reselling business, you generally do need to outsource certain processes such as listing and product photography. However, yes, I do recommend reselling flipping products to sell on eBay. Overall, it is a great way to make money on the platform, and it's the way that I recommend everybody get started selling on eBay. The next way you can make $1,000 per week selling on eBay is importing products from sites such as Alibaba and AliExpress. The process of doing this involves finding winning products like I talk about in this video, and then contacting suppliers on Alibaba, negotiating the price and the logistics, and then having the products imported to your location and then selling them on eBay. I've been importing for 1 year and I've been doing it seriously for just about half that time, and I've imported winning products that have generated over $10,000 in sales alone. With importing, your profit margin will vary greatly. However, from my experience from my own store, in terms of the products I have imported, the profit margin is just about 40%, meaning to make $1,000 on eBay importing products, you will need to sell $2,500 worth of inventory. It is my recommendation, in order to start importing products to sell on eBay, I would suggest having around $1,000 to invest into your business. Obviously, you can start importing with way less, and some products that I test, I do spend a lot less than that in the initial order, but the reason why I would say that you require that amount is because you may not be onto a winning product in your very first order, and that $1,000 amount would allow you to test a few different products and pretty much guarantee that you can find a winner and start generating consistent sales on eBay. The pros of importing products is that it is very scalable, and that you also do not need a lot of different products in your store to start generating a serious amount of sales. Also, contrary to popular belief, you do not need a lot of space or a storage facility to start. Myself, I prioritize prioritize items that are small in size and weight, not only because they cost less to ship, but also because they take a lot less storage space. The downside of importing products to sell on eBay is that it does cost more to get started. There are more risks involved in terms of dealing with suppliers. You do need to learn to communicate with suppliers before you start importing products to sell on eBay. And also, the margins are generally lower than if you were to resell used products. That being said, I do definitely recommend importing replenishable products to sell on eBay. I found a lot of success with it myself, and I really enjoy the scalability, and it's definitely a way that you can make $1,000 per week selling on eBay. All right, this final method is the one that I don't use personally, but it is definitely a way to make a lot of money on eBay if you know what you're doing, and that is eBay dropshipping. The process involved is listing products from sites such as Walmart.com, Kmart, and Target, among others, onto your eBay store for a higher price than they are being sold on those websites. Then when you get a sale on one of your listings, you simply purchase the product from one of those sites and then ship it directly to the buyer's address. My experience with eBay dropshipping is fairly limited, but I've done a lot of research in the area. I actually have tried eBay dropshipping. I did it all manually, and I was able to get a couple of $100 worth of sales, but I didn't really make much profit, and I ended up stopping because I had a lot more success reselling on eBay. Again, the margin can vary with eBay dropshipping, but it is a lot lower than any other method of selling on eBay. A 10% profit margin is fairly generous for eBay dropshipping, meaning that you would need to sell $10,000 worth of inventory just to make $1,000. The pros of eBay dropshipping are that it does have a very low cost to entry. When I tried eBay dropshipping, I didn't spend any money doing it, except for the cost of an eBay store subscription, but even that isn't necessarily required. It is very scalable. Simply by adding more eBay listings, you can increase the amount of money you make eBay dropshipping. And also, the main positive, in my opinion, is that there is no storage space required. Since you're not holding any inventory, you don't need to find a place to store any of your stock. The main negative of eBay dropshipping is that whether it is in line with eBay's terms of service is definitely a gray area. Dropshipping from sites such as Amazon can very easily get you banned, and depending on who you ask, you may have been informed that eBay dropshipping is banned altogether. According to the eBay website, while dropshipping from a wholesale supplier is allowed, listing an item on eBay and then purchasing the item from another retailer or marketplace that ships directly to your customer is not allowed on eBay. Just reading that makes me very concerned about trying eBay dropshipping, and therefore I can't really recommend it to you guys. But a lot of people online do seem to be making a lot of money dropshipping on eBay. So if you guys want me to give it another shot and do it as a challenge and show you guys exactly how I get on eBay dropshipping, make sure to drop a comment down below letting me know if you'd like to see that. As I said before, I don't have experience doing it, but people are definitely making more than $1,000 per week eBay dropshipping. So guys, those are the three ways that anyone can make $1,000 per week selling on eBay. My honest recommendation is to try all three if you're just looking to get started. For me, I started by reselling, and now I still do resell, but I also import products to sell on eBay. If you found the video informative, make sure to drop a like and also subscribe to my channel if you are new. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Bye.